he's caught by Greer. He breaks the tackle. 45 to the 50. Near sideline, outside the numbers of the 40. To the 30. He's down the sideline and collared to the 21-yard line. Big, big catch and run by Rashad Greene with 56 seconds remaining. 17 seconds, I formation now. Here's the snap. Winston rolling right. Throws the pass on the end. It's caught! It's caught! It's caught! Touchdown FSU! Kelvin Benjamin! Knowles retake the lead with 13 seconds remaining. Knowles retake the lead with 13 seconds remaining. Marshall looks right. Little hook and lateral they're going to do. There's the lateral to the right side. Now they go back a little flea flicker. Pass back on the left side. They got the numbers on the near side. Trey Mason. Mason running to the 30. Mason to the 35. He's tackled. Game over. Knowles are the champions of college football. Talvin Smith with the tackle that brings down Mason. Celebrate Seminoles. FSU 34. Auburn 31. Knowles third championship. And the SEC reign of victories of the BCS comes to an abrupt halt. A one-minute drive engineered by the one and only famous Jameis Winston. And the Florida State Seminoles snag victory from defeat. And a touchdown pass to Kelvin Benjamin gives Florida State the lead for good. Florida State 34, Auburn 31. The Knowles are the champions of college football.
Stumbling out, what's next for A&M?
Well, I think the guy that's in the best position, boy, it'd be great to be Jimbo Fisher right now at Florida State.
This afternoon, a report surfacing that Jimbo Fisher may be on the move to Texas A&M.
And now some breaking news. It is official. Jimbo Fisher will become the new head coach at Texas A&M.
And Monday, Fisher will be formally introduced as the Aggies' new head football coach.
This makes sense from a football perspective because they got a guy who has a national championship on his resume.
Fertile recruiting ground out in Texas area.
I think the other draw for Jimbo is just the passion that's at College Station and being in the SEC.
Everything is set up in College Station for a head coach to come in and have success.
A game of chess is like a sword fight. You must think first, before you move.
So this is what you were talking about. We both head coaches with
second field position, timeout, clock management was going to be huge. Auburn explodes the 14-0 start, and now we're in that back and forth chess match game. His career long. Set slow. It is no good. And Auburn takes a 14-3 lead to halftime here at Kyle Field. Now, the Aggies are just coming out now, and so Gus Malzahn is arguing for a penalty against the Aggies coming out of halftime. All right, so zero's on the clock, and the Aggies just now getting set. Gus Malzahn not going to win that argument, although you can see why he was arguing.
Every right to argue.
That's right.
Get down in it.
intercept. Ball is on the carpet, and Auburn has it. Daniel Thomas with the fumble recovery on the first play of the third quarter. Lumi Whitlow breaks free, down to the 25, down to the 20. First down for Auburn. He's actually at the 21-yard line. Dix from the gun. One step drop, throws it on the slant. Williams, does he get in? Touchdown, Auburn! Touchdown, Seth Williams on the slant. 9 yards for the score.
Pleased to meet you.
Hope rushes you four. Mond in trouble. Mond gets away. No, he doesn't. Back to the 25-yard line. Turns against the Boogie Whitlow, the 5, to the 3, to the 2, to the 1, dives into the end zone! Touchdown, Auburn!
What an answer right there by this Auburn offense!
Great response right there. Great job by Bo Nix using his arms, using his legs to get them down there inside the 10-yard line to be able to push it in.
Short field goal is good for the set small.
Off to Whitlow, he is dropped, and there's the second timeout, Jimbo Fisher, after Tyree Johnson makes the stop.
You'd like to score if you're the Aggies by the 3-minute mark.
All back up. Oh, lost it! Loose football scooped up by the Aggies. They somehow managed to run it down. That's Camoni out of the backfield across the 45. McBonagany there on the stop.
First down. They are a big play from getting this crowd back into it.
Chased again. Bond slips out. Bond at the first down and slides near the 36-yard line. So Bond goes scrambling for 16. First, you have to get in the end zone. Bond steps up, delivers. End zone caught. Touchdown, Aggies.
So this is going to skid around the ground, and somebody's got to make a play over there.
Here's the onside kick from them. One hop, and it is caught. The hands team, and it is Auburn football. And Whitlow puts his hands on it and secures it. Whitlow's not getting rid of that football. Only one timeout, one chance to stop the clock, and now the Aggies are open for a miracle.
And this is where Jimbo tells Mike Elko, they throw the ball, it's on me. You stop the run.
And now the Aggies out of timeout. An Auburn first down means you can take a knee.
A chance to be 4-0 in College Station. Who would believe that? This kind of raucous environment. I told you these Aggies would come to life. They got a touchdown. Look for a little quarterback run right here.
Nix will run it to the outside. Nix to the 40. First down, slides to the 38. Stays in bounds. Clock will roll down now for Auburn. 2013, 2015, 2017, 2019. Auburn is unbeaten at Kyle Field in College Station, Texas. And the tradition of Auburn winning at Kyle Field continues here this afternoon.